सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणमिजाति पूर्वं वेदागुच्छ प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाश मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखन्नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्तु निर्गुणपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्न भक्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we saw yesterday that even one who has Manda Bodha should not be doing karma and upasana if the interest is in moksha. Otherwise, that Manda Bodha also will go away if he has bhogeccha. So Manda Bodha Purushaha. Here Manda Bodha is a Bahuriya. Manda Bodha Yasya. Purushasya sa Purusha Manda Bodha. Earlier so far it was just used as Bhave Vitpatti. Here it is the Bahuri. There it was Tat Purushaha. So Manda Bodha Purushaha. So Yasya Manda Bodha Asti. Sa Purusha Karma Upasane Anutishtati Chet. तदा तस्य जातो अपि मंदबोधः नश्यति इति अत्र अयम् दृष्टान्तः। सो हियर मंदबोध इज तत्पुरुष, इट इज कर्मधारय तत्पुरुष, वे हियर इट इज बहुरी। सो मंदबोध पुरुष यस्य मंदबोध अस्ति तस्य मंदबोध जातः अपि नश्यति, कदा? कर्मोपासने अनुतिष्ठति चेत् तदा। सो यथा एग्जांपल इज गिवन, यथा पक्षिणौ शिशूनां पक्षोत्पत्ति पर्यंतमेव स्वांडानि सेवते। जस्ट लाइक अ बर्ड, यू नो द बर्ड व्हेन दी टिल दी एग्स आर हैच्ड, यू नो देन टिल देन इट सिट्स ऑन द एग्स एंड कीप्स इट वार्म, व्हाटएवर इज द प्रक्रिया, बट आफ्टर दैट इट विल नॉट बी सिटिंग ऑन द बर्ड्स, डेफिनेटली दे आर वीक एंड दे आर यू नो इन द इन्फेंट्स. When they are born, they have to be nourished. So the bird cannot sit on them, obviously. So quite a crude example to drive home the point that Manda Bodha is like the infant which is born. The jnana is in an infancy stage. You cannot put pressure on it by karma upasana, which are actually going to oppose. They are needed to hatch the eggs as though. So they are needed for the jnana to sprout. But once it has sprouted, once it has come out of its shell, you can no longer use karma and upasana, otherwise they will be destroyed. The jnana will be destroyed. It will be destroyed. Abhayam yatha bhavet tada samyag rakshati iti yavat. So what does the bird do? The bird protects its infants as soon as they come out of their shell, and then it does not do what it was doing earlier to hatch the eggs. Shishunam pakshotpatyanantaram andani na rakshati yadi pakshotpatyanantaram api andani rakshe tada andantaragata jalena ati sukumara shishupaksha dravibhuya vinashyeyuhu. So only when the shell is not broken, till then it will be on the eggs, but after that it will move away and the protection mechanism is different. It is not the same. Otherwise, the pakshis will become, they are very sukshma, the birds which are actually really unborn, they have not come out of the shell completely, rather. So they have to come out on their own. So whatever is the process that has to be followed, it is not the same process which was ongoing. Tatha jnanotpatte puromiva karmopasane anushteye natu jnanotpatte anantaramapi. Otherwise, just like the infant birds would die, similarly the jato api bodha. The manda bodha, jato api manda bodha will go away. It will not be there anymore. It will be destroyed, nashyet. नतु ज्ञानोत्पत्तेर अनंतरमपि यदि ज्ञानोत्पत्ति अनंतरमपि कर्मोपासने सेव्येते तदा बालपक्षी न्यायेन सो बालपक्षी न्याय हैज बीन शोन देयर मंदबोधोपि नश्येत यथा मातृरूप वृद्धपक्षिण्याः अंडसंबंधेन न कापि हानिः तथा दृढबोधस्य कर्मोपासनाभ्याम हानिर्न भवति वेयर एज यू लुक एट द बर्ड्स दे कीप ऑन being playful and then they fight with each other, they jump on each other, nothing happens when they are grown up. But in the infancy stage, the bird cannot jump on its, even if it's its own children, it cannot play with them the way it plays with a grown up pakshi, it cannot fight, etc. All this is not possible. But as a grown up, in no harm is there, they enjoy playing with each other, flying together. So similarly, dridabodha, once mandabodha becomes dridabodha, then there is no issue whether you do karma upasana or even karma for loka sangraha, has absolutely no binding on the jnani. The jnana should be drida. तथा दृढ़बोधस्य कर्मोपासनाभ्याम हानिर्न भवति यथा वृद्धपक्षिण्याण्डेन कर्तव्य उपकारो नास्ति तथा दृढ़बोधस्यापि कर्मोपासनाभ्याम कर्तव्य उपकारः नास्ति. Similarly, extending the example further, once the infant birds have grown up, बालपक्षीज have grown up, then the mother, whichever is the parent, you know, different birds have different ways in which, you know, whether the father or the mother deals with the infants. So the infant birds, when they grow, the parent has no duty towards it. There is no binding on the parent to take care of the child anymore. They have grown up. Although they are children in the perspective of the, in human beings, we say that, you know, however much ever you grow up, you'll always be smaller than your parents, definitely. But still, there is no duty per se. In Indian society, it is different, but still, you know, in the old society, the parents always think that there is a duty that they have to take care of their children. But still, there is no upakaraha kartavyaha. Similarly, karma upasana need not be practiced by a jnani. It is not kartavya karma anymore, kartavya upasana anymore. Tatha drudabodhasyapi karma upasana abhyam kartavya upakara nasti. There is nothing that the karma and upasana will bring in. Karma and upasana have duty to play. So if you personify the karma and upasana themselves, they have a duty to play as long as jnanotpatti does not take place. Or the setup for jnanotpatti does not take place. Jnana will arise on its own, just like the infant bird comes out of its shell on its own. To hatch the egg, to remove the, or to make way for the infant bird to come out of its shell, the mother bird has to do something, the parent bird has to do something. Similarly, to make the antakarana shuddha for jnana to arise out of it, in the exemplified, karma and upasana have a role to play. After that, the jnana arises on its own, and when it is arising, Shravana stage, one need not do karma upasana because karma upasana have nothing to deliver anymore. This is the comparison. What a beautiful example, because each aspect is comparable here. Thereby, kartavya upakara, upakaraha nasti karma upasana abhyam, dridabodhasya. तथाच ज्ञानिनो मोक्षार्थम अनुष्ठेयम् किञ्चिदपि नास्ति. Therefore, ज्ञानी does not have anything to be done or not done, as the case may be. So there is nothing to take up or drop, be it as a sadhana or for self-fulfillment. One may do, one may not do. This is jnani who has drida bodha. Iti mokshasya kim karanam iti tritiya prashnasya uttaram abhihitam. So Agrata Deva had asked the question, set of questions, where the third question as to what is the cause for moksha has been answered. It is jnana alone, without karma or upasana as samuchaya, or only karma and upasana leading to it. Only jnana is karana for moksha. Upasamhara. Now the conclusion of this particular section is being made. He somya mayopadishta sarvoyam arthaha sarvavedasaraha. What has been taught in the swapna of Agrata Deva is what? It is all Vedasaraha. And Vedasara is what? Veda Antaha. Antaha is Nishchayaha Saraha. That is Veda Antaha. So what has been taught by me, says the Guru, it is all Veda Antaha. Tasmadatra Tvam Shraddhatsva. Have Shraddha and it will work. There is no reason for it to not work. It has worked for all those who have had Shraddha in the Shastra. Shraddhavan Lavate Jnanam. There is no way you will not get Jnana, and definitely you will get Moksha. There is no doubt about it. That should be the level of Shraddha. Shraddha should be that this is the only Pramana. The interest of Shruti is only in my Moksha, nothing else. There is no Swartha. It is Apaurusheya. It cannot have any Swartha. That kind of Mother Shruti, if you want to personify her also, she is interested in my welfare, and I will definitely reach that goal, which is not a reachable goal at all. It is my own Swarupa, which is revealed by the Shruti. That is the Shraddha one needs, and Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam. Etadartha Jnanena Janana Marana Pravaha Rupo Paraha Yaha Samsara Moho Daya Moho Dadihi Samsara Moho Dadihi Samsara Sagara Ityartha. Tasya taranam anayasena te siddhyete tava. It will easily be possible for you to cross over this samsara sagara due to the shraddha. And what is that samsara sagara? It is janana marana pravaha rupaha. It is that kind of a flow of waters of the ocean. The real flow is janma and marana, which itself is not real. This is the process. Artha jnana, jnana, padartha jnana should take place, and then vakyartha jnana should take place. That mahavakyartha jnanena, etad artha jnanena, shruti artha jnanena, vedanta, upanishad artha jnanena. There, finally, the culmination is in mahavakya, which gives you aparoksha jnana. So that is the upasamhara there. Upadishtartha sangraha. Now, a collection of what ideas have been taught. Jiva Swarupam. Jiva has been talked about. What is the Swarupa of Jiva? What is the Swarupa of Ishvara? This is being discussed in detail now because an overview was given. And in this chapter, since it caters to the Mandadhikari, more details are needed per topic. So, Jiva Swarupam Kim? Jagat Karta Ishvaraha. Sa tava swarupat na bhinnaha. So what is jiva swarupa? Your swarupa. Your swarupa is nothing but Ishvara. Ishvara swarupa. Who is jagat karta? See, one may say aham chaitanya masmi. There is no problem in saying aham chaitanya because it is a fact. It appears to be a fact. There is no counter possible. But when you say that jagat karta Ishvara, then when you look at that, when you say Ishvara is Jagat Karta, and then you are told that you are that Ishvara, then there are so many questions. So tava swarupa na bhinnaha, when it is said, then my swarupa is to be questioned. Then only I will agree upon the teaching that Ishvara is not different from me. Otherwise it's difficult to agree. So Pujaswamiji used to say that this is like, you know, The guru says, you are Ishvara, it is like asking the Shishya to swallow a pumpkin. It's not possible, it is very difficult to swallow. It's a fact though, at the level of Sarupa, not at the level of Upadhi. We have seen this, but then now again it is revisited for the sake of the Shishya in a Swapna itself. And specifically the teaching is to Tarka Drishti. Tvam Sachidananda Rupam Brahmeva Asi Iti Prag Upadishtameva Vartham Punarapi Acharya Krupaya Shishyam Prati Sangrahena Upadishati He Somya. So Sangrahena, now it is a sum up. So details have been seen and they will keep on coming up in each chapter in different ways. In each context they will come up in a different way. So here Upadishat Sangraha, it's a collection, summary, basically it's a summary. Therefore Sangrahena Upadishati. But it is going to come up in the 7th chapter again. Because the details are split across as well, but different aspects have also been dealt with considering the Shishya. So the cloud example and the Ghatakasha Matakasha example, with the cloud and the reflection there within, Pratibimba in the Jala, Abhasa, these have been talked about earlier as well. So these are heard by Tarka Drishti also when they were taught to his two elder brothers in different ways. So Krupaya, this Krupa, why should there be a Krupa, or why do you infer Krupa? It is his duty. So one can say, you know, Brahmana Dharma or Guru Dharma is to teach. Why would you say it is Krupa? So there a very interesting perspective. Puja Swami is to say, you know, the Guru is free. Now why would he have an outlook of anything? He does not see anything other. The Shishya is not different. But then to see the Shishya's suffering as real, to walk in his shoes, that takes Krupa. That is the compassion. I don't care, I am free. This is not the attitude. Why do I care for others? There are no others also. And when you look at the way the parent looks at the child, the mother knows that the child's nightmare is mithya, but still she would look at the child and take care of the child because the child has real fear. Although the mother does not see, can't feel that fear, mukhyataya, or you know, that bhranta atma which is there, consideration of the sharira traya as oneself. That kind of sambandha is not there with the child. This sambandha with the child is gauna. This gauna sambandha is not there even for the, even that gauna sambandha is not there for the guru. But the guru still considers the shishya as the child. So that needs what is called an extra ounce of compassion, where you have to give reality to where it does not exist. So adhyaropasthaniya. That has to brought in, and then there is effort on the part of the guru to actually consider the shishya's issues as real and then try to solve them, apavadasthaniya. Thereby Krupa is discussed, and we see this in Ishvara Krupa, in Guru Krupa, in all sorts of Krupa, Mata Pita Krupa, Krupa is all over. So that's the manifestation of the Ananda Swarupa. Ananda Swarup of Atma manifests as compassion. Anyway, that's an aside. Punarapi Acharya Krupaya Shishyam Prati Sangrahena Upadishati. But there are other, you know, most of us do not like repetition. The more it is repeated, we say, you know, what is this? So why should it be repeated? So there is a role on the part of the Shruti, on the part of the Acharya, to take care of everyone who is available, and thereby repetition is there. Otherwise guru would have stopped the teaching at the level of the eldest son. So the Tattva Drishti got it quite soon. He didn't have to teach the Adrishti and Tarka Drishti at all, but then so many methodologies have been used. He Somya Tvam Dainyam Parityajya Nijaswarupam Janiyaha. Give up these, the Dainya Bhava, give up this limited aspect of yours, the wanting person that you feel you are, drop that idea, and then hold on to your real nature, nijaswarupam janiyaha, know that and hold on to it. Janmadiraitam shuddham brahma eva tvamasi. You are that shuddha brahma who ajata brahma, ajab brahma. You have had no birth, there is no shadvikara possible, because the first vikara isn't there, the follow on five vikaras are not possible, therefore you cannot have these doshas of the vikaras, you cannot have the limitations which you consider you have. Drishyam samastam jagat tvameva prakashayasi. This jagat karta ishvara, I cannot be, if you say no, you are revealing this in your presence. In your absence, this prapancha is not there. In your sapnavastha or in your shushupti avastha, the way this prapancha doesn't continue, that method if you use, you know that in your presence it is revealed. So by anvaya vyatireka, you know that when you are there, it is there, means it is mithya. Only when you are there, it is there. And when that is not there, that prapancha isn't there, even then you exist. So you are the one who are real. You lend this satta and bhana to this prapancha. So tvameva prakashayasi samastam jagat, not this part, the entire prapancha that exists. Swajnanena jagat sarvam tvameva srujasi. Then jagat karta I am not. I am just in the mere presence. In my presence the prapancha isn't there. In that prapancha's presence I happen to be. If you consider that srishti drishti vada, it is not true, because you yourself have created it from your own ajnana, the way swapna is created by you using your own ajnana. Ajnana is a shakti there. It is yat kinchit bhava rupa ajnanam. Punaha samastam jagat samrutyatvam avinashi avashishyase. Having created that, you have not changed at all. You have not created something out of you as in avidya, and then that avidya has lessened, that shakti has lessened. It is still there. So vikshepa is there. You are the vivarta karana. You use your shakti and you remain avinashi while the prapancha undergoes all kinds of changes and withers away. Mithya prapancham drushtva ishadapi tvamna khidyase. Because you are vivarta karana, it is an imagination, it's a kalpana. That srijana is a kalpana. Tvam devanavapi devosi. And the devas who have every role to play as per the context. You are deva because you are jyotana swarupa, you are prakasha swarupa, you are chit swarupa, who pervades not only this body, the devata sharira also. Therefore devanavapi devasi antaratmatva swarupatva tesham swarupatva. Tvam akhandananda ghanavasi. This dukkha is not possible for you because you are ananda swarupa, which is not having any gradations. There is no priya moda pramoda vritti possible. You are akhanda ananda swarupa ghana, ananda ghana. Jagat jiveshwaradayaha tvai mayaya swapnarthavat rajju sarpa shakti rajatadi vachya pratiyante iti. And then this prapancha is not real, although you have created it, that creation is just pratiti matra sattaka. So the jiva, jagat and ishvara, all this triad that you have been struggling to know, who am I, what is this prapancha, who created this prapancha, what is the sambandha between the three, all these questions which lead to moksha have been answered now, because all these three have been imagined in you, and the sambandha is also imagined in you. Swapnarthavat, just like the swapnapadartha, the adhisthana satta alone exists. There is no swapna prapancha, triad of swapna jivaha, swapna jagat and swapna ishvara, all those three are imagined in you. Rajju sarpa shukti rajatadi vachya pratiyante. And they appear just like the sarpa appears in Rajju or Rajata appears in Shuktika. Iti patra ete shlokaha bhavanti. Then these shlokas are there which have been created by iti grantha krita eva ete shlokaha. So the grantha karta sadhu says दैन्यं परित्यज निजात्म रूपं सच्चित् सुखं पश्य सदा द्वितीयं। सो सदा अद्वितीयं पश्य हे सौम्य। सो द स्वप्न गुरु एज वेल एज वी हैव साधु हियर हु टीचेस अस सो एज दैन्यं परित्यज हैविंग गिवन अप दीन भाव। दीनस्य भावः दैन्यं, शेंज प्रत्यय कॉजेस वृद्धि। सो दैन्य आदि वृद्धि, परित्यज्य हैविंग गिवन अप दैट इंडिविजुअलिटी, इंडिविजुअल जीव, आई एम लिमिटेड, आई नीड दिस, आई वांट दैट, आई डू नॉट वांट दिस। सो ऑल दीज राग द्वेष आर पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन यू आर इंडिविजुअल। व्हेन यू आर हैविंग दैन्य भाव इट इजंट देयर, यू हैव टू गिव अप, दैट इज नॉट ट्रू। देयरफॉर हैविंग गिवन दैट अप, निज आत्म स्वरूप सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप सच्चित सुखम पश्य सदा अद्वितीयम, ऑलवेज नॉट वंस इन अ व्हाइल। दिस शुड बी एट द बैक ऑफ योर माइंड एंड देन एट द फोरफ्रंट ऑफ योर माइंड। दैट इज द ओनली साधना, देयर इज नथिंग एल्स टू डू। जन्मादि शून्यम परमेव तत्त्वम ब्रह्मासि शुद्धम निजबोध रूपम। सो जन्मादि शून्यम षड्विकार शून्य परमेव तत्त्व, तस्य भावः तत्त्वम सर्वस्य भावः तत् इज भगवान भाष्यकर वेरी नाइसली सेज तत्। व्हाट इज तत्त्वम? He says tat is sarvanama. What is sarvanama? Sarvesham nama or sarvasya nama, however you take it, sarvanama stands for everything. In pronoun also, in English you say pronoun is a proxy noun. It can stand for anything as a proxy. Appropriately of course, but here sarvanama says it stands for everything. That tat, tasya bhavaha tattvam. So this is sarvabhavaha. सर्वभाव इज तत्व, वॉट इज द रियल स्वरूप, सर्वस्वरूप दैट इज तत्व, वेरी नाइसली डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय भगवान भाष्यकार। दैट परम तत्व यू आर ब्रह्म असी, परम तत्व इज ब्रह्म, दैट परम तत्व यू आर सर्वस्वरूप इत्यर्थ शुद्धम। यू कैनॉट बी एफ्लिक्टेड एट ऑल, यू कैनॉट हैव दुख, यू कैनॉट बी टेंटेड बाय पाप, जस्ट लाइक दिस सूर्य हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ whatever is done in its in his presence. Surya being pullinga, we prefer to say he is instead of its presence. Nijabodha rupam, nityabodha rupam, never does that jnana chidrupa jnana go away alukta druk. So that sakshi is your swarupa. Drishyam samastam drugabhinna atma त्वमेव विद्यतोयसि स्वभाव स्वभासा। सो स्वभासा दैट भान दैट यू हैव, अस्ति एंड भाति, अस्ति देन भाति, इट इज देयर एंड इट शाइन्स फोर्थ, दैट इज ड्यू टू योर चैतन्य बिकमिंग मैनिफेस्ट एज ज्ञान, एंड देन दैट इज कंसिडर्ड एज कॉग्निशन, मिसअंडरस्टूड एज इंद्रियजन्य विषयजन्य। सो दृश्यम समस्तम दृग अभिन्न आत्मा, ऑल दैट इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम यू। सो इन योग सूत्र ऑल्सो इट इज दृष्टा दृषि मात्र। सो वॉट इज सीन इज नथिंग बट दी दृष्टृ स्वरूप। हु इज दृक? यू आर दैट साक्षी दृक, एंड द प्रपंच इज अभिन्न फ्रॉम यू। त्वमेव स्वाज्ञानतः सर्वमिदं विसृज्य पश्चाच्च संवृत्य विशिष्यसे अजह। सो अजह, अजह सन विशिष्यसे, यू रिमेन एज अ होल पूर्ण। सो पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदम, दैट मंत्र टेल्स यू दैट फ्रॉम पूर्ण, व्हेन पूर्ण कम्स आउट पूर्ण रिमेन्स, द इन्फिनिटी लिमिटलेसनेस कैनॉट बी टू। सो इफ यू टेक अवे इन्फिनिटी आउट ऑफ इन्फिनिटी, इन्फिनिटी स्टिल रिमेन्स, दैट इज युअर स्वरूप। This prapancha which is tending to infinity has come from you and you still remain whole. How so? There are no holes left, you remain whole, you remain the infinite, limitless. So paschacha samrutya vishishyase ajaha. So the jagat karana, not only srishti but laya karana as well as the maintenance is due to you. So swa ajnana. स्वज्ञान बिकम्स द कारण देयर। स्वज्ञानतः, स्वज्ञानतः सर्वमिदं विसृज्य पश्चात् संवृत्य। सो Srijana and Samharana shows the sustenance also. So you play the role of Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, yourself. And in all these stages, you still remain Ajaha because you are the Vivarta Karana. Mithya Prapanjam Drishtvapi Na Kinchit Khidyate Tava Mano Devadi Devopi Tvameva Sukha Niradhihi. So Devadi Devapi Tvameva. It has already been mentioned earlier. He is just doing summary in kind of a set of shlokas. तन्माया वशतो भाति जगज्जीवेश विभ्रमः स्वप्नवद् रज्जु सर्पादि शुक्तिका रजतादिवत्. सो लाइक स्वप्न और शुक्ति रजत इट ऑल अपीयर्स इन यू देयर फॉर यू आर द ओनली वन हु इज एग्जिस्टेंट एकमेवाद्वितीय ब्रह्म त्वमेव असि. ज्ञान साधन वर्णनम समरी ऑफ ज्ञान साधन व्हाट इज इट मोक्षो हे वर्गस्य उपदेशः व्हाट शुड बी गिवन अप बाय मुमुक्षु. In jnana sadhana, vairagya is one of them. So one has to give up. That vairagya should be viveka janya. So he somya padarteshu dridasakti rupam ragam lobham dvesham kamancha duri kuru. Keep away raga lobha dvesha kama. Says this guru to the shishya. And this raga is towards the padartha, whether it is a person or a thing. Other than you. You keep them away. Dridhasakti rupam, there will be vasana, but don't let them carry you away. So be alert. Do not be negligent, because manushya janma is a blessing for moksha. We don't know when will we get it again if we miss this opportunity. So we shouldn't miss this opportunity. Thereby, raga lova dvesha kama should be kept away. So you keep it away, says the Guru to the Shishya. Gitacharya also says, Narakasya Dwaramidam. The Traya. And then elsewhere he says, Kamesha Krodhesha. So all these have been taught to be kept away in Shruti Smriti Purana. Ragalova Dvesha Kamagranam Sarvasam Rajasamanasa Vrittinam Upalakshanam. And this is just one listing, it is not complete. You can add others, everything that is going to come up from Rajasa, Manasa, Vritti, all those have to be included there. Sarvasa de Upalakshana. Sarvaha Rajasa Tamasa Vrittayaha Samulam Unmulayittavya Iti Yavata. So Rajasa, here there is an Upalakshana for Rajasa Vritti. Raga, Lova, Dvesha, Kama are possible for a non-lazy person. A lazy person cannot be said to have raga for any vishaya because he prefers laya. He prefers to sleep. One can say he has raga towards shushupti, but it, you know, when people say, no, I love to sleep for longer hours. But what is that? It is not love for a different vishaya. One prefers to go back to Swarupa in a very odd manner where you cannot know your Swarupa. It is like saying that I would like to have a lot of wealth which I cannot use. What use is dhana if you cannot use it? So you are in your Swarupa, but you never know it. And to know your own Swarupa, you have to take efforts in Jagrat Avastha. That may continue in Swapna Avastha. For a sadhaka who is much advanced, the japa or, you know, dhyana or, you know, the vichara, all these continue in swapnavastha also. The quality of the dreams are also an indicative of sadhana progress. Many have these anubhavas. But if you cannot work in the jagratavastha because of laziness, going back to sleep is not going to let us know our Swarupa. So there is no raga towards any other vishaya due to tamas. And therefore raga, lobha, dvesha, kama are not possible as tamasa vrittis. They are all rajasa vrittis. These rajasika vrittis are to be included with these four words. So it is an upalakshana for rajasa vrittis, but it is not only rajasa vritti because sarvaha rajasa tamasa vrittayah. Tamasa vrittis also have to be included. They have to be brought in. They have to be dropped. Otherwise, you cannot have sattvika vritti itself. Sattvika vritti is possible only when tamas is countered by rajasa vrittis. From tamas, you cannot directly go to sattva. So, these rajasa vrittis mean that you have to win over tamas as well. Therefore, sarvaha rajasa tamasa vrittaya samulan samulam unmulayitva, having uprooted all these tamasik and rajasika vrittis, what should you do? You should further in your sadhana. Iti yavat. Rajasa samasa vrittayo jnanasya virodhinyaha. These rajasa and tamasa vrittis are opposed to jnana, because jnana is sattva swarupa, sattvika. Vritti rupa jnana is also sattvika. Just like karma and upasanas are opposed to the vritti rupa jnana, these rajasa tamasa vrittis, this tamasa vritti will make a person fall asleep during shravana itself, let alone manana and nididhyasana. During shravana itself, not even Shuddha Shravana, the person is snoring. You know, especially when there are repeated sections, people go to sleep. Tasam unmulanam vina jnanam na udiyat. Jnana won't even arise if tamas is not won over by rajas and rajas is not won over by sattvika dharmacharana. Tasmat tasam nivritti jidnyasur avashyam apekshita iti jidnyasur heya varga upadeshaha. What should be given up has been taught here in this section. Jnanasya bahiranga sadhana upadeshaha. So what is the bahiranga sadhana? Which is not directly leading to jnana, but without that jnana isn't possible, indirectly leading to jnana. What are those? The sadhana chaturte sampatti ityadi, viveka vairagya shamadhi shatka sampatti mukshutva. We know these. Iti etani chatvari jnanasya sadhanani. So viveka, atmanatma viveka, nityanitya viveka, so tattva bodha, vedanta sara level, we have seen all this. Vairagyam, dispassion towards bhoga here and there. Iha mutra phala bhoga viragaha says tattva bodha. That is vairagya. Shamadi shatka sampatti, shamadama uparati titiksha shraddha samadhanam. All those six are needed. Indriya jaya, karmendriya, jnanendriya, manaha, jaya, using buddhi, which is refined by viveka, that kind of buddhi should be used to cultivate shamadhi shatka. Then uparati is actually nyasa, leading to sannyasa, withdrawal from everything. It is not just mental sannyasa. So one has to give up karma. Being in the, one should give up kamya karmas. Being in the ashrama, ashramatraya, or if one is a sannyasi, then one has to give up the nitya naimittika karmas also. Shraddha, samadhana, so titiksha also, titiksha, because every time you are bombarded with pairs of opposites. So whether it is a weather which affects the body, or whether it is sukha dukkha that affects the antakkarana, one should watch them over as passing. Guna guneshu vartante. Titikshasva bharata. So there also Bhagavan Krishna in Gita says that titikshasva shitoshna sukha dukkhadaya. So all shitoshna sukha dukkhada, what are these? There is only tanmatra sambandha. Therefore, have titiksha, bear them, forbear them. So then, shraddha in the shastra, shastra and guru vakyeshu, shraddha, vishwasa, shraddha, vishwasa should be there, that it is catering, shruti and acharya are catering to my welfare, there is no swartha, this should be the shraddha and respect in the sampradaya. Samadhana, the mind should be composed enough that understanding can take place, and if in the yogic process also samadhi can take place. Samadhana has a wide range of meaning, starting with composure, where one can attain completely, attain the shravana or attain the shravana patha completely. So that presence needs a mind free at least for that duration, so that shravana can take place and it can work, so that a seed can be planted by Shruti and then it can sprout and grow into a tree, which is Drida Bodha. That itself is a sampatti. There is no other sampatti needed for a mumukshu. Mukshutvam will be the resultant, and this is only moksha iccha. Tivratara moksha iccha is not moksho me bhuyat, but tivratara iccha. Iti etani chatvari jnanasya sadhanani. These are bahiranga sadhanas to jnana. Teshu viveka pradhanam sadhanam. Viveka, being the foremost, is placed first. It is primary. Without viveka, vairagya, smashana vairagya, all these are, this jihasa vairagya, all these are useless. They can be useful if the earlier viveka done in the earlier janma triggers in that scenario. But otherwise, this smashana vairagya is useless. Generally. So, prayena. Otherwise, viveka is definitely needed. Therefore, teshu. Teshu nirdharane saptami. Teshu sadhana chatushteshu viveka pradhanam sadhanam ataha pratham tasya kirtanam. Therefore, it is mentioned first, because without viveka, all these others will not only be possible, they will be all bhranti. Vivekena eva vairagyadikam utpadyate. So, vairagyadikam vivekena eva utpadyate. They will not even be born. There will be a bhranti of vairagya, but it won't be there. It won't last. And what doesn't last isn't there really. Atascha acharya shishyaya vivekam eva pratham upadishati he somya samsara samudram mrugatrushnika jalasamam mithya iti varam varam chintaya. Do chintana again and again. So that is pariksha lokan. Do the loka pariksha, anubhava pariksha, your own anubhava. You have so many, you don't have to tap into another's anubhava. You don't have to search for any other anubhava, because you have enough anubhava to look into, inquire into and understand that they are not nitya. There is no sukha in vishayas. You don't need to taste the, you don't need to have every anubhava. You have had it across janmas. You don't need to recall them also. You don't have to create them afresh. You don't need to have a taste of cyanide to know what cyanide is. Cyanide is poison. So dosha drishti can be there in cyanide even by inquiring into it, but not needing anubhava. So what anubhava you have is sufficient. If you don't have anubhava, just understand them without wanting that anubhava, and you can have vairagya, which is viveka janya. Because they are all fickle and they are mithya. Just like the mrugatrushnika jala sama. So like jala, water which is seen in the desert, it's mirage water. So samsara samudra is like that. Samsarasya mithyatvoktya mithya samsara kalpana adhisthana bhuta atmana mithya. The adhisthana is satya because it is the adhisthana. Adhisthanatvat satya. Why? It cannot be mithya adhisthana on which mithya kalpana is possible. Adhisthana should always be satya, and that adhisthana is atma, pratyagatma, you, your own swarupa, says the guru to the shishya. Kintu satya iti uktam bhavati. By saying that samsarathya samsarasya mithyatva uktya, once you say samsara is mithya, that samsara is seen by you, it is anubhuta by you, that you are adhisthana. By saying samsara is mithya, you are satya, has been said indirectly. Aindrajalikena pradarshyamana, sorry, kintu satya iti uktam bhavati. Aindrajalikena pradarshyamana, pradarshyamanan adbhutan padarthan pashyantam putram pita evam uvacha. So the child is looking at a magical show. The father has taken him. Father tells the child, who is struck with wonder with the magic show, Indrajalikena pradarshyamanam amravrukshadikam sarvam mithya. The magician has brought up a mango tree. He's in a illusion. So he has brought that up. Now the father tells the child, the mangoes aren't real. Pituridam, what is that? It is all mithya. This amra vruksha, the vruksha is mithya, let alone the vruksha phala amra. The amra phala looks like, you know, very juicy mangoes, but they are not real. And you are wonderstruck as to how, you know, out of season you are seeing mangoes. It is all mithya. How did he bring up a tree out of nowhere? Mithya. The creation is mithya. The produce is mithya. The created produce is mithya. So your indulgence is not needed. It is all bhranti. Why would you indulge in it? So pitur idam vachanam shrunavan putra aindrajalikam api mithya iti na janati. So this putra, who knows that this vrikshadika is mithya, vrikshadi is mithya, amra vrikshadi, delusion, he does not know. The magic is also mithya, the magical produce is mithya, all of this is mithya. Kintu satyam eva tam janati. He thinks that it is all real. Evam eva jagan mithya iti upadeshena atma satya iti shishyaha vijanatu iti ayam avipraena eva acharyaha samsara samudram mithya iti akatayat. So why should the guru tell the shishya that it is all mithya? Because the shishya does not know. That's all it is. Iti jagan mithya atma satya. इति जगन मिथ्या आत्मा सत्यः इति गुरुः विवेकम् उपदिदेश. सो गुरु गेव द उपदेश दैट जगत इज मिथ्या आत्मा सत्यः. सो व्हाट भगवान भाष्यकार सेज, भगवत पादाचार्य एल्सवेयर सेज, श्लोकार्धेन प्रवक्ष्यामि यदुक्तं ग्रंथकोटिभिः. ब्रह्म सत्यम जगन मिथ्या जीवो ब्रह्मैव नापरः. सो जगन मिथ्या ब्रह्म सत्य, ब्रह्मात्मा ही सत्य. So that teaching is given first, and Atma Satya, this Nishchaya, is not possible, and Atma Brahma, that Nishchaya is not possible unless Jagat Mithyatvam is known. If one is told Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma, thereby Sarvam Jagat will become real, that is a wrong understanding. That will not lead to moksha. First, jagan mithyatva buddhi should be there, otherwise viveka is not necessary, vairagya will not be possible. If one is already taught in the first instance that all this is you, everything is brahma, which is you, then why would one drop anything? One will continue to do anything and everything the way one was doing. No viveka, no vairagya is needed, no teaching is needed. Just one statement, Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. Shruti does not do that. Shruti teaches Mithya, Jagat Mithya first. The Dvitiyatva Buddhi can be taken away only when the Dvitiyatva Buddhi, which is there, should be analyzed with Viveka, and one should be given up, the other should be picked up. Only then this Aikya can be taught. Because this Aikya is not Aikya between something and something else. It is Aikya which is never segmented. Everything else is a Bhranti. The segmentation is a Bhranti. So the teaching of Aikya is actually teaching of removal of that which is Mithya. So Mithya has to be taught first, otherwise you cannot remove anything. There cannot be Bhagatyaga Lakshana teaching possible. It is unnecessary also. Therefore this Aham Brahmasmi teaching is possible एंड सर्वम खल विदम ब्रह्म कैन बी अंडरस्टूड एप्रोप्रिएटली ओनली वेन जगत मिथ्यात्व निश्चय इज देयर देन ओनली इट कैन बी सेड दिस जगत इज यू वेन दिस जगत इज यू हैज बीन टॉट इनिशियली विदाउट जगत मिथ्यात्व निश्चय देन वैराग्य आदि इज नॉट पॉसिबल देयर बाय नॉलेज विल बी अरोनियस द सेकेंड टाइम when it is taught after teaching jagat mithya and then it is said this jagat is you then you know that is kalpana in me swapnavat otherwise swapnavat is not possible swapnavat mithya is the teaching it is not sarvam khalvidam brahma sarvam mithya adhisthana you brahma or satya is the teaching it is not that sarvam satyam Otherwise, sarvam ekam satyam could have been the teaching. That is not the teaching. You don't find such teaching anywhere. Ekam eva advitiya brahma, that teaching means that there is no analysis and no segmentation possible. There is no segmentation which was there earlier also. So, jagat mithya is the first teaching and then aikya teaching is possible. Atma satyatvam can be held on to only then. अतश्च विवेक देन विवेके सिद्धे इतर साधनानि स्वयमेव उपदेशं विना एव सिद्धेयुः वंस विवेका इज देयर देन वैराग्य इज अ डेफिनेट रिजल्ट ऑफ इट परीक्षलोकान कर्मचितान ब्राह्मणो निर्वेदम आयात इट इज नॉट समथिंग टू बी कल्टीवेटेड विवेका शुड बी देयर विवेका विल नेसेसरीली रिजल्ट इन वैराग्य इफ वैराग्य इजंट देयर It is very clear that Viveka isn't there. In fact, this is analyzed by Bhagavan Vyakhyanakara in Viveka Chudamani. There he analyzes that and says, you can infer one with the other. The Shamadhi Shatka also works in that manner. One won't have it unless the Viveka is there. Therefore, If Vairagya is there, then Viveka is definitely there. If it isn't there, Viveka is definitely not there. Others are going to automatically follow. Upadesham Vina, one need not be taught as to you have the Shama Dama, because Vairagya will lead to what? One will not indulge in any which way. Therefore, Viveka will naturally lead to Vairagya. Vairagya will result in Shama Dama Adi Sampatti, and then Moksha Ichha is automatic. Very nicely said as Upadesham Vina Eva Siddhyehu. Atascha Viveko Upadeshade, Atascha Viveko Upadeshat Eva Itara Sadhana Upadesha Api Arthat Siddha. So by teaching Viveka, all other things are as good as being taught. Iti Jnanasya Bhairanga Sadhanani. So Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, all these are Bhairanga Sadhanas. Without them, Antaranga sadhana is not possible, Shravana Mana Nidhyasana are not possible, which are Sakshat sadhana for moksha, in that also Shravana. Jnanasya Antaranga sadhanam to Shravana adhikam meva. Shravana Mana Nidhyasana is the direct means to moksha, the direct means to Jnana, which is moksha karana, or that itself can be called as moksha. He Shishya Shravana Rupa sadhanena Jnana Rupam Bhanu Bhasadhya Jnana Rupam Tamo Vinashaya. So, ajnana rupam, tamaha vinashaya, this should be bhanu bhasa. So, shravana rupa sadhanena, shravana rupa sadhana, shravana manana nididhyasana, but in that shravana is the sadhana, antaranga sadhana, that sadhana will lead to jnana, therefore jnana rupam, Shravana Rupa Sadhanena Jnana Rupam Siddhyati, you can say, and then what is that Jnanotpatti really? That is that Jnana, that is like the Tamaha taken away by the Surya Prakasha, similarly Ajnana is taken away by Jnana. So, Ajnana Rupam Tamaha Vinashaya. That is the, so you have to split the sentence there, otherwise you cannot have Jnana Rupam and Ajnana Rupam in Samanadi Karanyam. So here you have to put a comma or a full stop. So Shravana Rupa Sadhanena Jnana Rupam. Phalam, we can say Phalam or something of that sort. Tama iti अंधकारस्य अज्ञानस्य च नाम। सो तमा इज अज्ञान और अंधकार यूज इन बोथ मीनिंग्स। तत्र अंधकार उपमानम अज्ञानम उपमेयम। सो अंधकार मीनिंग ऑफ तमह इज द एग्जाम्पल एंड द सेकेंड मीनिंग अज्ञान इज द उपमेय इज द एग्जाम्पलीफाइड। सो तमह इज यूज इन बोथ केसेस। Tama is reused as an example as well as the exemplified. Sadrishya aniyogi upameyam, sadrishya pratiyogi upamanam iti jneyam. So these are the tarka words aniyogi and pratiyogi. So sadrishya aniyogi, aniyogi is basically where you see it, and then pratiyogi is the counterpart. Thereby upameya and upamana also defined in that sense. We look at jnana swarupa in the next part. Sukam nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyattu nirmanam param sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak param maha tadeva annamattu nirthime nishchitamatihi tatsat. Namaste.